Have you ever wondered why there are so many different voltages that mean the same thing? What's up, everyone? I am Dustin Stelzer with Electrician U. So let's talk about this whole voltage thing. So a lot of times you're gonna come across people saying 110, 115, 120, 125 volts, and we're really just talking about the same thing. So why are there so many different things? Well, there's different classes, so some equipment will use things differently. Some power that is supplied from a utility company is gonna be kind of in a range. So there's nominal voltage, there's utilization voltage, there's distribution voltage, there's a bunch of different voltages. So when we talk about these things, we're kind of saying the same thing, but there are very specific reasons why these numbers exist. So a long time ago, back when we really started using power in the US, the US power system was at 100 volts. And they were using 100 volts out in public street lighting. But then as time went on, people wanted the lights to be brighter, so they would bump the utility voltage up to 110 volts. And this is where the whole 110, 220 thing comes from. This is what it was at for a very, very long time. And then probably within the last like 50 or 60 years, it was bumped up even more for the same effect to try to get a little bit brighter street lights. So we went up to 120 and 240. And for the majority of people out there, when we talk about things, that is what we're talking about nowadays. That is the modern convention. But you'll notice that materials have a little bit different voltages with them as well. So regardless of the nominal voltages that we may talk about out in the field, like, hey, is there 120 at that receptacle? Or hey, is there 110? People still just use 110 and they still use 220. Usually a little bit older people that have been around a lot more, where that whole nomenclature was still kind of during transition when they first started their career. But nowadays, it's really not 110 and 220, it's 120 and 240. But you will notice that there are some materials out there that have things like 130 volts. There's a lot of lamps and bulbs that are meant for commercial use that are rated at 130 because voltage can kind of fluctuate throughout a property throughout the day with usage. So the more things that are being utilized, there might be voltage drop, there might be raised voltages. So a lot of lamps, bulbs will burn out if they're not rated to be able to handle a little bit higher current because of the higher voltage that's happening. Now, before we get into it too much, I want to remind everybody that we have continuing education available. So we are getting more and more states added throughout the rest of this year. I think we have 10 states now that we're approved in. So if you want some continuing education, tired of the same old crap all the time, come to Electrician U, come check out, see if we have your state available. And if we don't, keep checking back because we are constantly adding more states. Now, normal supply voltage from a utility company is going to be within a certain range. It's not going to be guaranteed to be at the same thing at all times. There's a lot of other things going on in an area that might affect what the actual delivered voltage is, but they tend to stick within about 114 volts to 126 volts. This is what you would call the utility voltage or the distribution voltage at that property. So they know that anywhere within that range, if they've got a voltage of like 124 or 118, the equipment's still gonna operate the same way. There are little fluctuations. Most equipment is designed to still operate within this range. So if you have something that has 114 volts with your multimeter and you're gonna plug a vacuum cleaner in there, or if you have 124 volts, that vacuum cleaner's still gonna operate without there being any damage to it. So that's why there's kind of an acceptable range. But really the things that need to be looked at are the issue of voltage raising and the issue of voltage dropping. So in the case of voltage rising, you'll notice that you have things like receptacles or plugs, cords, that are usually designed at 125 and 250. So if you look at a receptacle, some of them are just rated at 125 volts, 20 amps, or 125 volts, 15 amps. Some of them are rated 250 volts, 50 amps, or 250 volts, 30 amps. So that amperage number is still saying that this is the amount of current that's designed to be drawn through the device, but the voltage is typically on the higher end. And that's because when voltage rises, there's a directly proportional relationship with amperage. If you raise the voltage, you're gonna raise the amperage too. So they're saying that even though a nominal system of 120 volts, might have 118, might have 122. They're saying that the maximum voltage that this device can handle, because of the amount of current that's going to be drawing through it, is 125. And some receptacles you'll notice will say 125/250. That means that this one receptacle is designed, regardless of the prongs that are being plugged into it, you know, those will have to match up, but you can feed 125 volts through this, or you can feed 250. It's designed to carry both. Now, if voltage goes down, then current's gonna go down, so there's no worry about any damage to a receptacle if there's less current flow because of less voltage. Then we notice things like motors, which are kind of inverse of that. We notice motors are usually rated at 230 and 460 volts. So 230 is obviously representative of the 240 volt, 250 volt range, but it's lower, it's on that low side. And then 460, the same thing. We often have like a 277, 480 volt service somewhere, but instead of saying 480 on that motor, it's gonna say 460. And the reason is because there's voltage drop that occurs when loads are turned on. And so manufacturers of motors always know that there's generally going to be like a plus or minus 5% in voltage. And so when they rate a motor at a certain voltage, they're saying that we are giving you the low end of what the voltage is that this motor can operate without there being any kind of large damage or anything to it. They don't worry about it so much on the high end, it's more of a concern on the low end, because at a certain point, if you keep going lower, then that motor's not going to operate well. It's the same thing if a motor goes too fast and starts operating a lot higher, that it can also damage things. But with motor ratings, they're always concerned about that low end, because voltage has a lot more tendency to drop, especially in an area with a lot of things going on or at a facility, a lot of things happening. The more loads that you have on, you're going to start dropping the overall voltage at that facility. So they're saying, at what point will this motor stop working? And that's why they give us the lower values of 230 and 460. So typically when you're seeing voltages, just as a little bit of a review, you're not gonna see equipment really with 110 and 220 on it. Most of the time when people are saying 110, 220, that's just some old school language for the modern times of saying 120 and 240. You will have things that are rated 230, 460, and that tends to be motors. You're gonna have receptacles that are rated at 125 and 250, but just generally in there, we're talking about voltage classes. So, hope you learned something. Thank you guys so much for watching. Really appreciate your attention, and I will see you in the next one. Best music and video.